Welcome back to Elite Dangerous, and here I'm going to show you how to take out bigger ships with a very easy trick. I hope this ship is wanted. So I'm going to first scan it with a death warrant scanner, I mean kill warrant scanner. You don't need to do that, it's just to get more bounty. Right, and don't attack it yet. Open the number one panel and go into the... Ooh, Anaconda. I'm going to do Anaconda instead. Where is that? I'm gonna definitely take out that Anaconda. Maybe not alone, but I will wait until someone attacks. Oh, he's getting attacked. He is going down. No, he's not getting attacked. He's in the wing, but it's gonna be easy, trust me. I just want to scan him first. And his friend in there. Let's scan them. I still need backup, I can't take two of them alone. The ship I'm using, it's a Vulture, it has two large hardpoints, and it's a lot of firepower, guys, it really is. But I will tail them a little bit and wait until someone starts shooting at them so I can take out that wing body, and then I have the Anaconda all for myself. And looks like they started attacking someone, so let's go do this. So what you want to do is open the side panel, go into sub targets and target the power plant. Oh shit, that, okay, they're attacking two of them. I'll take that asp scout off their ass. Oh shit, you can't target anything else while targeting that, so that should go fast. My lasers are actually doing so much damage to the hull that it's actually going down. Alright, and now do the same thing with Anaconda. Where is the... power plant, there we go. Where did it go? Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it's not hostile. It didn't even notice that I took out his wingman. It's right on top of me, what the fuck? The Vulture is best attack ship, I'd say. Alright, see how this Anaconda goes down so easily. If you can't, don't attack it from the front. I mean, never attack big ships from the front, because that's pretty much a death wish. And if he starts turning, just do this. With Vulture, it's... well, it's no problem, because it's really... oh, shit. It's really agile ship, so... I got the gimbal thing, so it's like... just need to get the shields down. There we go. And pulse laser and the burst laser are the best one. Look at the power plant damage on the left side. Oh my god, what the hell. That scared me, that was outside somewhere. Alright. Gimbal is not exactly the best, but I prefer gimbal because I can actually maneuver at the same time. And it's almost down. There we go. How is it still driving? It should be losing power now, any second. Come on. Maybe not. There we go. And that's it. The ship is, well, neutralized. It can't do anything. It should blow up on its own after, I don't know, how long. But as you can see, it can't drive, it can't do anything. I'm not sure if you can even repair it. I don't think you can. Yep, there we go. It's gonna blow up any second now. Or not? I'm not sure. Maybe they updated the game. It used to blow up like when the power plant went, but right now it's just standing there, so just take your whack at it. Yep, it just needed a little bit more. And that's how you do it, guys. It's very easy. I just thought I'll give it a good look. And that's my ship in here. That is the Vulture, like I said. It's really small, agile ship with two large hardpoints. And I'm using pulse laser and the burst laser. They are really good in like this kind of combo. I really like this ship. It's really... Is it purple? I haven't even inspected it. I just bought it. But this is not like the cheapest class of ships, but it's definitely a lot cheaper than Anaconda. I think I spent like 8 million on it, something. Yeah, it is kind of purplish. I like it. I also like the sound. Just listen to that. Ow. But yeah, you can take out any big ship like this. Anaconda is pretty much the biggest there is. There is Federal Corvette, and I think there was one more something. The Imperial Clippers are the hardest ones because they're so agile, they turn around faster than you can actually, you know, take out their power plant. But the trick is always the same. And best weapons for that is the pulse laser and burst laser combo, or pulse lasers alone actually do more damage than any other laser. Even though it says that the beam laser does more damage, it's not true. Use the same combo as I have, that's amazing. Let's see what's going on there. Ooh, Imperial Clipper! That's almost down. Let's do the same thing. Power plant! Ooh, shields online. Yeah, right, I don't think so. Like I said, these are really nightmare, but I'm not afraid of them. Not with this ship. Let's do this. Did I already disable something? Look at him, he's like spinning around. Oh, he's trying to jam me. Wombie the Wombat, what the fuck? See, that's what I'm saying, they're so agile, they can turn so fast. But he's going down nevertheless. See, that's what they're doing. Well, the AI is not the smartest, but he almost had me there. Nah, he's going down. The power plant is almost down. I think you can only hit the power plant from below and above. Where are you going? Oh, for fuck's sake, stop jamming my stuff. There we go, power plant down. And look at the hull damage. You will have to shoot them a lot more. Not sure where the power plant is exactly. I think it's below. Kaboom! Really easy trick, guys. See, I didn't even take a single hit with this, so... I think the Vulture is the best assassination ship. It's really agile, really good. It's not the fastest, but... it's really good.
target destroyed.
I put about 8 million under it. The ship itself was about 2 million, I think. No, it was 4. And I put another that much under the outfitting. I have shield boosters, all that, but you don't really need any of that. You can just take it off. If you're a good pilot, you don't need it, but things do happen. So I hope this helps, and I will see ya next time.